What's up, everyone? Welcome back. All right, so doing something a little bit different for you guys today. Going to be doing some NHL 2004 for you guys today. Been quite some time since I've picked this game up, but I figure, you know, again, what the hell, might as well do something a little bit different for you guys today. And I do have a particular reason for wanting to play this game today. I do want to give you guys a couple of updates as to some stuff that has transpired at my workplace that's actually pretty interesting, so... Yeah, I want to share that news with you guys, but also I actually want to do some straightening up in my studio. So while I'm busy doing some other things, I'm going to record some of this for you guys, so there may not be like as much commentary of mine during these videos as usual. Because again, I'm going to be doing other stuff, like, you know, again, just cleaning up my studio a little bit, which is also my bedroom, by the way. So, yeah, I figured I might as well just get some of this done. I had to wake up early today, actually, because it's kind of weird, but one of my coworkers hit me up and was like, hey, you want to hang out? And I'm like, yeah, sure, why not? You know, it's kind of weird, though. Like, usually people don't, like, ever, like, hit me up and just are like, hey, you want to hang out? Like, haven't had that happen since, like, fucking high school. So, yeah, kind of weird, but, you know, I had to wake up early today to get shit done. I'm actually kind of proud of myself. It's only like 9:16, and I've already gotten a bunch of Rock Band stuff done for you guys, so yeah, I'm kind of shocked that I actually managed to get my lazy fat fucking ass out of bed this morning, so yeah, that was pretty cool, I guess. Again, just going to be kind of busy doing my own thing here with cleaning up my studio and whatnot. Going to be working on some of that this morning. So again, there may not be a whole lot of commentary during these videos, but during this first game, I am probably going to do commentary, like, straight up for all these videos, you know, like usual. But during the other videos, I'll just be in the background, you know, cleaning up my studio and shit. Because, again, I may or may not have company today, so gotta make my studio look all pretty, I guess. Well, as pretty as it possibly can look. I mean, it's never going to look that pretty, to be honest. But, yeah. So... gonna be working on straightening that up, and yeah, just kind of a weird day, you know. It's kind of a bit cloudy out today, a little bit gloomy looking, but yeah, it's just kind of weird because usually my coworkers like never hit me up and are just like, "Hey, you want to hang out?" Like that's like literally never happened to me in the like 6 years that I've worked there. Well, that one other time, one coworker did hit me up and I hung out with him, and it was fun. But yeah, very rarely happens. But yeah. Anyway, gonna get this fucking party started here. So we have these two teams battling it out. I'm not even gonna try to pronounce the one team. I know the one team is pronounced Hanover, but the other team, I'm not even gonna try to pronounce the name of that team. And again, as usual, I'm just gonna be watching the AIs battle it out. So, yeah. So we'll see how it goes. So yeah, something did happen at my workplace that's kind of interesting. So to put things in perspective for you guys again, for those of you who don't know, I pre-record all my videos several months in advance before I actually get around to uploading them. So again, for those of you who don't know that about my YouTube channel, that's typically how I do things, is that I pre-record all my videos several months before I actually get around to uploading them. So keep in mind, at the time I'm recording this is currently, I want to say, October 28th? I think it's the 28th in 2020. So that's the actual date that I'm recording this on. I don't know when I'll actually get around to uploading this video, but yeah. So, the way that they're doing things, because again, I live in Illinois, and the way that our governor's doing things is that if any particular region, because he's like divided up the state into regions or whatever for the COVID response thing, for the, you know, COVID pandemic, if any particular region has a positivity rate above 8% for 3 days in a row, they're going to shut down, like, businesses again. We're going from phase four back to phase three, basically, which is where you're not allowed to go out to restaurants and eat. Restaurants are only allowed to do carry out and shit like that. For, I think they said, at minimum 1 week, we have to go back to that. until the rate goes down or whatever. I'm not entirely sure the specifics behind that, but regardless, if we reach a positivity rate of above 8% for 3 days running, then we have to go back into, you know, lockdowns and whatnot. And it just so happens that my particular region of Illinois that I live in breached the 8% mark for 3 days in a row. So now Governor Pritzker has decided to shut us down again. But here's the thing that surprised me, actually, is that the owner of my restaurant, and I did not see this coming, is actually going to defy the order, along with a lot of other restaurants in my particular region. A lot of restaurants in the region are going to defy the order against the lockdown, which, again, I'm genuinely shocked about. So when we had the lockdowns for the first time, you know, we fully complied with the lockdowns. Our place fully complied. But this time around, the owner's actually like, no, fuck this. We're not doing this again. This is bullshit. So we're actually going to defy the order. It's supposed to go into effect on Saturday, but we're staying open for full dine-in. So I don't know exactly how things are going to go. I don't know if the cops are going to show up or what's going to happen, but it's kind of interesting, you know? So, yeah. I mean, my theory is that there's going to be so many restaurants around that are just going to defy the order that it's not going to matter, you know? At a certain point, you know, the cops won't be able to enforce all of it. You know, they won't be able to close down every single restaurant that decides to stay open. Because there's a lot of them that are going to defy the order and stay open, not just our restaurant. So this coming Saturday is going to be really fucking interesting. Because, yeah, we're staying open despite the order. So we're striking the order. Normally a strike is where you don't work, but in this case we're striking against the governor's order to close down again. So, yeah, because our restaurant's remaining open for dining despite the order. So, yeah, it's interesting. I like it, though. I like the decision to stay open. I think that is an excellent decision. It's a great move that helps out, you know, all of my coworkers who wouldn't get to work otherwise, you know, who would miss out on making money. So it's good for, you know, all my coworkers. I'm happy for them that they've decided to fight this, you know. The owner of my restaurant, he said he's lawyering up. He's getting a lawyer, and he's going to fight it. And in the meantime, we're not shutting down. We're staying open. Telling the governor to go fuck himself. I personally like the decision. You know, if people are that worried about catching the coronavirus, they can stay home. No one's forcing them to go to our restaurant, you know. People know the dangers of coronavirus at this point, and if they're willing to take the risks, why not let them, you know? So, yeah, our restaurant's actually staying open despite the governor's order, so I don't know what's going to happen, but it should be interesting nonetheless. So I'm kind of excited to see what all transpires with that. Should be interesting, again, if nothing else. So we'll just have to wait and fucking see what happens. But yeah, I kind of like it, you know, we're fighting the system. Now, I do give a lot of crap to the management staff sometimes, you know, on my videos. But I gotta say, as far as their overall handling of the, you know, of our workplace during the pandemic and their overall handling of the COVID pandemic, I gotta say they've done an exceptional job overall. The managers and the general manager in particular, they've done a phenomenal job, I personally believe. So, yeah, you know, give credit where credit's due, right? Alright. So, yeah, I mean, again, you know, I have given the management staff my fair share of shit. You guys know that. And especially the general manager as of late. But I gotta say, their overall handling of you know, dealing, you know, navigating this whole COVID pandemic, they've done a phenomenal job, I have to say. Our management staff has done an excellent job. They were dealt a shitty hand, and they've done a great job, I think, overall of dealing with the COVID pandemic. So again, credit where credit is due. You know, I give credit where credit is due, and the managers have done an excellent job. Again, they were dealt a shitty hand, literally the shittiest hand you can possibly get, and they made it work, man. They have made it work. So I got to say, you know, I do have my issues with the management staff at my workplace, don't get me wrong, but I think overall they've done a fantastic job of handling the COVID pandemic, of handling our workplace during the COVID pandemic. I got to say, they've done a phenomenal job. So, again, credit where credit is due. They've done a great job. And I'm really happy with the choice of, you know, bucking the governor's order to close down again. And we're just staying open. You know what? Fuck the governor's order at this point. There's a lot of other restaurants that are doing the same thing and following suit as well that are not going to listen to the governor's order, that are disobeying the governor's order. And I'm proud to say that I'm part of a business that is allowing people to do what they should have the right to choose. This is fucking America, the land of the free. We can't be free if we're not even allowed to make up our own minds. You know, the government is not supposed to be able to control every aspect of our day-to-day lives. It's a dangerous day in history when the government starts telling you, hey, do this, shut up and obey, it's for your own good. It's a dangerous day in history when the government starts pulling that kind of shit. So I really like I love the decision that our owner has made by saying, you know what, we're fighting this order, we're giving people the right to choose. If they want to come out to our restaurant, they know the risk of catching coronavirus. The risk is very real. Don't get me wrong, COVID is not something that should be taken lightly, but at the same time, people know the risk, and if they're willing to take it, why not let them? That's how things should work, because this is fucking America, the land of the free. That's how shit works in America. Let people make up their own goddamn minds. The government should not have that much control over our day-to-day lives. And so, yeah, it just, it's a great decision, I think. I think it's a great decision by our owner, and I am surprised to say, but I am very proud of his decision in that. You know, to be honest, I didn't really think that my owner would have the balls to do it. I'm going to be straight up honest. I didn't think he'd have the fucking balls to do it, but credit where credit is due. Again, him and the management staff have impressed me over the last day. I have to say they have been very impressive over the last day. You know, credit where credit is due. You know, I'll give them plenty of crap. I'll be the first one to give them crap when they do stupid shit, but the owner and the GM have done a phenomenal job the last day deciding to stay open and saying, you know what, fuck this. We're not going to take it anymore. We're going to give our people a chance to, you know, make money that they need to survive, you know? Because that's the other thing, too, is that people need these jobs. They need to work. They need to make money in order to feed their families and shit. You know, and I work with some older people who have kids that they need to feed. They need these jobs in order to feed their kids and feed themselves. You know, they need these jobs. So, it's just overall a great decision on the owner's part. I know he's mostly driven by the idea of, you know, because he wants to make money. He's a very money-driven person, no doubt there. But it does also help out the employees as well, who are still able to work because of his decision to decide to tell the governor to go fuck himself, and he's staying open. So it's good for all of the employees as well as the owner himself. It's a good, smart move. Now that we know more about the coronavirus and stuff, it's a really good, smart move. It's a very smart move. So I am very proud of the decision that they have made, and I'm gonna be honest, I've never been more proud to work there than I am at this point. Like, again, I never thought they'd actually have the balls to do it, but I am very proud of them for making that decision. That's not an easy thing to do, you know? Going against the law on this one. Going against the law is never a easy thing, but sometimes it is the right thing to do. And, yeah. I mean, the law is not the end-all, be-all, you know? Laws were made by people. People make mistakes. It is not perfect. So the people who make the laws are not perfect. The people who make these decisions, who are in charge, are not perfect. Definitely not perfect. In most cases, they're stupider than your average person. In our governor's case, that's more than true. Because Pritzker is a fucking retard, honestly. He is. He's a fucking retard, and I'm saying it. Anyone who's got a problem with it can suck my big fat fucking balls. The only smart thing Pritzker ever did was legalize marijuana because of the tax revenue. And that's the only smart thing he's ever done. Other than that, everything else he's done is fucking retarded. Hey, do you like paying more for gas? Do you like paying more for online goods? Yep, because that's what you'll have to do in Pritzker's fucking Illinois. Every time I fill up gas at the fucking, you know, fill up my car at the gas station and see how much extra I'm charged because of Pritzker's fucking gas tax, I say to myself, I'm like, thank you, JB, you fucking idiot. You fucking asshole, you fucking fuck. Thanks, JB. Every time I order something online and they tax the hell out of it now, I'm like, thanks, JB, you fucking asshole. And it's funny, because when he was originally running his campaign, he's like, oh, I'm not going to raise taxes on the middle class. I'll only raise taxes on the upper class. Pretty sure everyone needs gas, not just the upper class. I'm pretty sure everyone orders shit online, not just the upper class. Because I can tell you one thing, my family sure as hell ain't upper class. We're maybe like middle class or low, I would say low middle class, especially like my dad. Is definitely low middle class, I would say. So, like, definitely, you know, like, oh, I'm only going to raise taxes on the upper class. Bullshit. Everyone buys gas. It's, you know, like, middle class, lower middle class. Even poor people still need gas to put in their, you know, beater cars and shit. You know, like, yeah. Really, asshole? You're only going to raise taxes on the fucking rich? Really? Because I ain't fucking rich, and you raised the shit out of my taxes, you piece of garbage. Fuck you. So I love the decision by my owner. By not necessarily my owner, because I'm not owned by anybody, because I'm a human being. But the owner of the restaurant, I really love his decision to decide to stay open. That's a really ballsy move, but really smart move on his part. So we'll see how it goes. Hopefully we don't get forcibly shut down by the cops. Because, I mean, if the cops show up, I'm doing what they tell me to do. Because if you fuck with the cops, you're in for a world of hurt. Or worse, you could literally get shot and killed. And this is not worth getting shot and killed over. So, but that's why the owner is getting a lawyer and he's going to fight this thing. But in the meantime, we're staying open. You know, because fuck it. We're done putting up with the governor's bullshit. He's a fucking fat lying piece of shit. So, yeah. That's the way it is, honestly. That's the fucking way it is. So, yeah, really loving the decision by the owner. So, starting on Saturday, we'll have to see what happens. It's going to be interesting, but I can't wait to give you guys some updates on that. So yeah. You guys are definitely going to want to stay tuned. So, sorry, I know I got kind of off on a tangent there, but, yeah, I just needed to give you guys that little update on my workplace. So, yeah, we're staying open despite the order, so it's going to be interesting, guys. May have some interesting stories to tell you guys coming up soon, or may end up just nothing happens to us, you know? So, we'll have to wait and see. You know, again, my theory is that so many restaurants are going to, you know, buck the order, you know, and disobey the order that the cops aren't going to be able to enforce it. So there's going to be so many restaurants that are disobeying the order that they're not even going to be able to keep up with it. You know, they're not going to be able to shut them all down. So, I actually don't think that anything drastic is going to happen to us. I really don't, but you never know. You never know. I would say maybe there's like a 25% chance that something might happen, but I'd give it a 75% chance that nothing's going to happen to us. Because, again, so many restaurants are done with J.B. Pritzker's bullshit, you know? Like, yeah, the coronavirus is dangerous, but it needs to be put in perspective. People die from all kinds of shit all the time. You know, it fucking happens. That's a part of life. There's risks involved with every decision you make. Every time you hop in your car, you do it with the knowledge that you may, you know, you may get in a crash and die. Everything you do is a risk. The coronavirus is no fucking different. And if people are willing to take that risk, why not let them? Again, this is America, the land of the free. Let people make up their own fucking minds. The government should not act like our parents and tell us what we can and can't do. That is not how the government was designed in America. It was not designed to control every aspect of our day-to-day lives. It's not how it fucking works in America, and that's bullshit, and people will not stand for it. Which is why so many restaurants have decided to disobey the order. And I'm proud to say that our restaurant's one of them. So to that I say, hell fucking yes. So we're going against the system, guys. We'll see how it goes. I may or may not have some interesting stories for you guys. So I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be an interesting interesting experience, I think. It'll be an interesting experience. So yeah, it'll be something to tell the kids about someday, you know. You know, back during the coronavirus pandemic, my boss said, you know what? Go fuck yourself, JB. You know, because I'll probably be old by then, but, you know, whatever. All right, anyway, guys, I know I went on a bit of a rant there, but shit needed to be said. I'm sorry. Sometimes shit just needs to be said, and that just needed to be said. But either way, I'm looking forward to this weekend. It should be, again, a very interesting experience, and I'm looking forward to it. So, yeah, maybe I'll be able to tell you guys some more about that next week as well. But yeah, it should be interesting. All right, well, either way, guys, stay tuned for the next part of this game. And until then, peace out.